या अकॉर्डिंग टू।
सर रिकॉर्डिंग स्टार्टेड, वी आर लाइव नाउ।
हरिओम हरिओम, नमस्ते टू ऑल। प्रोस्ट्रेटिंग एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ ब्रह्मनिष्ठ सद्गुरु स्वामी विराजेश्वर सरस्वती एंड द एंटायर गुरु परंपरा, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल ऑफ अस, टुडेज डिस्कोर्स ऑन विवेक चूड़ामणि विल कंटिन्यू। लास्ट टाइम We had stopped at the shloka number 286, verse number 286. That is, Acharya Shankara Bhagavatpada is explaining on the sub chapter called Adhyasa, false identification, how the disciple should always think and then concentrate and then give up the false identification or Adhyasa. And he continues with a set of shlokas on the same line of argument, the Sadguru explaining to his Shishya. Last time, Acharya Shankara Bhagavatpada had taken the example of the body itself, which is full of sweat, urine, and then fecal matter, covered by the bones and connective tissues, the muscles, muscle layers, and outermost skin. And then what we see is the outer surface, outer view of the human body. But what is inside is as if baggage of fecal matter. So he was giving that example last time. Malamam savayam vapuhu tyaktva brahmi bhuya kruti bhava. That is where we had stopped. Now he continues. Now in the next shloka, Acharya takes up the famous Vedantic example. All Mahatmans, always they have used this example, and Acharya has used this example in most of his bhashyas here and there. That is the Ghatakasha and Mahakasha. Mundina shlokadalli Acharyaru Ghatakasha Mahakasha da bagge helta adara ondu ತುಲನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ಘಟಾಕಾಶ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಪರಿಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಗಡಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ಮಡಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಜಾಗ, ಅವಕಾಶ ಅಥವಾ ಆಕಾಶ, ಖಾಲಿ ಜಾಗ. ಮಠಾಕಾಶ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ಅಂತರಿಕ್ಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಕಾಶದಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಿರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಈ ಅವಕಾಶ ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಆಕಾಶ ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಜಾಗ. ಮಠಾಕಾಶ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ವಿಶಾಲವಾದದ್ದು, ಘಟಾಕಾಶ ಅದೇ ಆಕಾಶ ಒಂದು ಮಡಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂಕುಚಿತವಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಗಡಿಗೆ ಒಳಗಿನ ಖಾಲಿ ಜಾಗ ಗಡಿಗೆ ಇರೋ ತನಕ ಕಾಣುತ್ತಲ್ವ, ಗಡಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ಒಡೆದು ಹಾಕಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಖಾಲಿ ಜಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಯಿತು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಣಲ್ವೇ. ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು ಮಹಾಕಾಶದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸೇರ್ಹೋಯಿತು, ಐಕ್ಯವಾಯಿತು. ಆ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಘಟಾಕಾಶಂ ಮಹಾಕಾಶ ಇವಾತ್ಮಾನಂ ಪರಾತ್ಮನಿ ವಿಲಾಪ್ಯ ಅಖಂಡ ಭಾವೇನ ತೂಷ್ಣೀಂ ಭವ ಸದಾ ಮುನೇ. ಘಟಾಕಾಶಂ ಮಹಾಕಾಶ ಇವಾತ್ಮಾನಂ ಪರಾತ್ಮನಿ ವಿಲಾಪ್ಯ ಅಖಂಡ ಭಾವೇನ ತೋಷ್ಣೀಂ ಭವ ಸದಾ ಮುನೇ. ದಿ ಕೀ ಫ್ರೇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಶ್ಲೋಕ ಈಸ್ ತೋಷ್ಣೀಂ ಭವ ಸದಾ. ಹೇ ಮುನೆ, ಸದಾ ತೋಷ್ಣೀಂ ಭವ. ತೋಷ್ಣೀಂ ಲಿಟ್ರಲ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಡಿಸೈಪಲ್ ವತ್ಸ, ಯು ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್. ತೋಷ್ಣೀಂ ಭವ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸದಾ ಕಾಲ ಮೌನವಾಗಿರು, ಮೌನದಲ್ಲಿರು ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಗಡಿಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಆಕಾಶ ಅಥವಾ ಜಾಗ, ಗಡಿಗೆ ಒಡೆದಾಗ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ನಮ್ಮ ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಅಂತರಿಕ್ಷದ ಆಕಾಶದ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಂದಾಗಿ ಸೇರಿ ಹೋಗುತ್ತದೆಯೋ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನೋಡಪ್ಪ ಶಿಷ್ಯ, ನಿನ್ನ ಜೀವಾತ್ಮನನ್ನ ಈ ಜೀವವನ್ನ ಏನ್ ನೀನ್ ನಾನು ಅಂತ ದೇಹ ಅಂತಃಕರಣ ಯುಕ್ತವಾದ ಈ ಜೀವವನ್ನ ನಾನು ನಾನು ಅಂತ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಈ ಜೀವವನ್ನ ಪರಮಾತ್ಮನಲ್ಲಿ ನಿನ್ನ ಒಳಗಡೆನೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಪ್ರತ್ಯೇಗಾತ್ಮ ಆತನಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಲಯ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡು, ಆತನಲ್ಲಿ ಐಕ್ಯ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡು. ನೀನು ಬೇರೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಜೀವ ಬೇರೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಜೀವಾತ್ಮ ಬೇರೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಬೇರೆಯಲ್ಲ ಭಾವ. ಹಾಗೆ ಐಕ್ಯ ಮಾಡಿ, ಐಕ್ಯ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಖಂಡ ಭಾವೇನ ತೂಷ್ಣೀಂ ಭವ ಸದಾ, ಸದಾ ಕಾಲ ಮೌನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರು ಅಂತ ಮೇಲ್ಮಟ್ಟದ ಅರ್ಥ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಸೇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಿ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಪಾಟ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇನ್ ವೇದಾಂತ. ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ ಪಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್. Whereas the space outside in the Akasha, in the entire universe, surrounding us around, that is vast, infinite, incalculable, you can't even imagine. So just like when the pot is broken and the space within the pot, Akasha, merges automatically with the Mahakasha, space outside, you can't identify. Where is the space of the pot mixed up in the outer space? No identification. No identification. It is something like, elsewhere Acharya has given another example for the same to understand, to make us to know correct. See, for example, take the holy river in our country, Ganga. Ganga Maya, Ganga Mata. From the origin point of view, from Gomukh and Gangotri onwards, it is called the holy river Ganga, flowing and flowing and flowing downwards from Rishikesh and Haridwar, downwards and then into Uttar Pradesh, all the while, passing through so many holy places and then touching Kashi also, Patna also, and then finally it merges with the Bay of Bengal near Ganga Sagar area. Oh. The main river, of course, joins with the Brahmaputra river now within the Bangladesh and joins the Bay of Bengal. Now, as long as it is flowing individually on the earth surface, you identify as Gangama, Gangamaya, Gangama, Ganga river, the holy river. The name is identified. You can see the river flowing. Once it merges with the sea water, in that mouth region, you go and stand, take out a pot full of seawater there and try to identify where is the Ganga water here. You can't identify. The Ganga has already merged with the sea. It has become the seawater itself. Just like that. When the pot is broken, the Ghatakasha merges with Mahakasha, outer space. It loses the individuality. As long as the pot is there, you call it as the space within the pot. Once the pot is gone, when it is smashed, then it loses the identity. The space mixes, joins, totally merges. These are all words for communication. Actually, there is no difference at all between the space inside the pot and the space surrounding the pot. Are outside. So one and the same. For our sake, we call different names. That's what I said. Ghatakasham Mahakasha Iva Atmanam Paratmani Vilapya. So just like that, your own Jivatma, your Jiva Bhava, with Antakkarana, I am so and so, you have identified with the body and the mind complex. Remove that feeling and you totally merge your jiva into the Paramatma itself. Akhanda bhavena tushnim bhava sada. So once you can reach that stage of merging yourself in Paramatma, Pratyegatma, once you are totally by the grace of Guru or God, come out of the false identification adhyasa that you are the body, and then you completely merge with the Pratyagatma inside and you become Paramatma itself. Then what happens? Acharya says, once you do it, then toshnim bhava sada mune. Then you remain silent. Toshnim means silence, golden silence, mahamauna. So once the brahmajnana, atmajnana dance, what happens? All the karmas will go away. The prapancha disappears in the spiritual sense, in the metaphysical sense. Please remember, the whole space, universe disappears. Why? Because the Atmajnana Sampanna personality will see only Brahma, only that Paramatma Vastu everywhere, the only Adhishthana substratum as Paramatma. The entire universe is pervaded by the same supreme consciousness, the supreme reality, the supreme awareness, and he himself is that supreme awareness. So there is no second, there is only one all the time. So the prapancha in that sense disappears. The moment jnana dawns in. So toshnim bhava acharya says here means remain silent. It happens, of course. So for our understanding, it is not just literally keeping quiet, not talking. It also means to that extent, don't talk. That means talk only when it is required, essential. As far as maintaining your body in this world of mithya. The real sense, tushnim bhava, remain silent, means, Acharya hints here, the insight is you have to remain without desires. You remain desireless all the time. That means remove the sankalpa and vikalpa, the thought processes. You control the mind, your mind will be controlled by yourself, and the thought processes what are generated will die as soon as they are generated, because you become a pure witness. Once you become a witness, once you start watching the thoughts will subside and subside and disappear. So that actually means tushnim bhava, real silence, thoughtlessness nature, the thoughtlessness state. That is the bliss, the blissful ecstasy. All jnani mahatmans always revel in that, always reveling. Then he continues, Acharya. Svaprakasham adishthanam swayam bhuya sadatmana brahmandam api pindandam yajyatam malabhandavat. Now, svaprakasham adishthanam swayam bhuya sadatmana ब्रह्मांडमपि पिंडांडम यजत् यजत्याम मलभांडवत्. Again, Acharya is using the word मलभांडवत्. In the last shloka, he had used the word मलमांसवयम् वपुः. मलमांसमयम् वपुः. वपु means his body, sharira. मलमांसमयम्, he had used that word in the previous shlokas. Now he uses the word मलभांडवत्. मलभांडवत् means, look, my dear disciple, this body, this physical body, covered by the outermost skin, is nothing but malabhandavat shariram. It is a baggage full of fecal matter, urine and sweat. That's what Acharya is making so, again, clear, so that a sense of a dejection should come into the mind of the qualified disciple, so that the disciple should not start all the time appreciating his own physical body, appreciating his own beauty, or dwelling too much on the maintenance of his own body. That is why Acharya is pinpointedly, subtly, directly using these words. स्वप्रकाशम अधिष्ठानम स्वयं भूय सदात्मना ब्रह्मांडम अपि पिंडांडम यज्ञताम मलभंडवत् ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೋಡಪ್ಪ ಶಿಷ್ಯ, ಸತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪರಾಗಿ ಚಿತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪನಾಗಿ ಆನಂದ ಸ್ವರೂಪನಾಗಿ ಸರ್ವ ಆಶ್ರಯಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣನಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಪ್ರಕಾಶವಾಗಿ ಜ್ಯೋತಿಷ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪದಿಂದ ಬೆಳಗ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಪದಾರ್ಥವೇ ನೀನಾಗಿದ್ದೀಯ. ಇದನ್ನ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಿನ್ನ ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ನಿನ್ನ ಅನುಭವಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಇಡೀ ವಿಶ್ವ, ಈ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡ ಮತ್ತು ಈ ನಿನ್ನ ಪಿಂಡ ಶರೀರ, ನಿನ್ನ ಶರೀರ ಸ್ಥೂಲ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮಗಳ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ನಿನ್ನ ಶರೀರ, ಪಿಂಡಾಂಡ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದೇಹ ಶರೀರ, ಮನಸ್ಸು ಬುದ್ಧಿ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಯುಕ್ತವಾದ ಅಂತಃಕರಣದಿಂದ ಕೂಡಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಶರೀರ ಪಿಂಡಾಂಡ, ಸುತ್ತಲೂ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಶ್ವ ಇದು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ನೀನು ಈ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡ ಪಿಂಡಾಂಡ ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟುಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇದನ್ನ ಮಲಮೂತ್ರಗಳನ್ನು ತುಂಬಿರೋ ಪಾತ್ರೆಯನ್ನ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಿಸಾಕ್ಬಿಡು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಹಳ ಸುಂದರವಾದ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಸೇಸಿಯ ಸ್ವಪ್ರಕಾಶಂ ಅಧಿಷ್ಠಾನಂ ಸ್ವಯಂ ಭೂಯ ಸದಾತ್ಮನ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಂಡಂ ಅಪಿ ಪಿಂಡಾಂಡಂ ಯಜ್ಞತಾಂ ಮಲಭಾಂಡವ. ಲುಕ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಡಿಸೈಪಲ್, ಸಿ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, knowing, experiencing firsthand with the awareness that you are the ever-existing Brahma Padartha, Parabrahma Vastu. You are that self-shining Parabrahma Vastu. You are that Sat Swarup. You are that Supreme Consciousness. You are that Parama Chaitanya Vastu. You are that Chit Swarupa. You are that Ananda Swarup. You are eternally present without birth and death. And you are eternally shining. So knowing that, hence give up this false identification that you are the body. Your body is nothing but baggage full of fecal matter, urine. Always try to remember like that. Don't develop attachment, too much of love towards your own body. Okay, the body is there. Due to prarabdha, body has come by birth. The body has to face all the good and bad things in the life as long as the life is there. So don't give too much of love and importance to this body because it is malabhandava. It is a baggage of fecal matter, baggage of urine, baggage of sweat. So detach yourself from Brahmanda, the cosmos, and pindanda, your own body. Brahmanda refers to the outer cosmos. Pindanda refers to your inner cosmos. So both you discard. Both you discard. Yajyatam. A sort of an injunction by Acharya. You discard. Because you are Brahma Swarupa. You are not the body. So the point here is every time Acharya. Why? Every time he comes back to the same point. You are not the body, you are Atma Swarupa. Why a jnani, a Mahatman, Sakshat, Shiva Swarupa, Shankara, Bhagavad Pada, all the time repeats, without hesitation, without any iota of fatigue, with so much patience. Bahala taalme inda, prati sala, prati barige, ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಇದನ್ನು ಯಾಕೆ ಪದೇ ಪದೇ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ? ನೋಡಪ್ಪ, ನೀನು ಆತ್ಮಸ್ವರೂಪ, ನೀನು ದೇಹ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಶರೀರ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನೀನು ಆತ್ಮಸ್ವರೂಪ. ವೈ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಮರಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್? ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಡೀಪ್, ಗೋ ಇನ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್, ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕಸ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ಲಿ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಿ ಆತ್ಮಸ್ವರೂಪ. ಯು ಆರ್ that Parabrahma Swarupa. Your reality is different. You have mistaken, superimposed your body as yourself. Your outer I feeling that I am the doer, I am the karta, I am the bhokta. So the kartrutva and bhoktrutva, you are imposing yourself falsely on your own psyche, which is totally false. Give up that feeling, adhyasa. pulsate. Why repeatedly? He said, if you start hammering the truth 1,000 times, 10,000 times, 1 million times, every day hammering the same truth to the disciple by the Sadguru, at least a day will come. A day will come, fortunately, in this birth itself, by the grace of the Guru. A day will come that sudden enlightenment will occur, jnanodaya will occur, the dawn of the jnana will take place, the dawn of the reality will happen so that the disciple really wakes up from this so-called dream called samsara. So that is the reason why all Mahatmans repeatedly, without fail, with all the patience, they go on advising the same thing, over and over and over and over again and again. You have to pardon me. Today, while starting this discourse, age factor maybe, it slipped off, the Mangalacharana Shloka slipped off from my mind. From my mouth, I once again apologize to my Gurudeva and to the entire Guru Parampara. I'll repeat that and then we'll continue. Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha. Om Mahasaraswatyai Namaha. Sadashiva Samarambham Sri Shankaracharya Madhyavam Asmadacharya Pariyantam Vande Guru Parampara. Shruti Smruti Purana Namalayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Padam Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayam Sutra Vashya Krudo Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Sarva Vedanta Siddhanta Gocharam Tamagocharam Govindam Paramanandam Sadgurum Pranadosmiham. Om Namo Bhagavate Virajeshwaraya Hari Om. Acharya now again continues. Chidatmani Sadanande Deha Rudha Aham Dhiyam Niveshalingam Utsrujya Kevalo Bhava Sarvada. Chidatmani Sadanande Deha Rudha Aham Diyam Niveshalingam Utsrujya Kevalo Bhava Sarvada. Nodappa Shishya, ee shariravve nanu anta ee buddhi shariravad mele naat hogidiyalla, aa buddhiyanna neenu Nityananda Swarupa, Chidananda Swarupanagirtakkanta Mangalakara ನಿನ್ನ ಚಿದಾತ್ಮನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತ್ಯೇಕಾತ್ಮನಲ್ಲಿಯೇ ನೀನು ನಿನ್ನ ಬುದ್ಧಿಯನ್ನು ನೆಲೆಗೊಳಿಸಿ ನೀನು ಈ ದೇಹವೂ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಥೂಲ ಶರೀರವೂ ಅಲ್ಲ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ಶರೀರವೂ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋ ಭಾವ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ನಿನ್ನ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ನೀನು ಅಸಂಗನಾಗಿರು ಕೇವಲೋ ಭವ ಸರ್ವದಾ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲೂ ನೀನು ಅಸಂಗ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನ ತ್ಯಾಗ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ಸಂಗರಹಿತನಾಗಿ ಇದ್ದು ಬಿಡಬೇಕು ಇದು ಭಾವ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಸೇಸಿಯ ಚಿದಾತ್ಮನೇ ಸದಾನಂದೇ ದೇಹಾರೂಢಾಂ ಅಧೀ ಅಹಂ ಧೀಯಂ ದೇಹಾರೂಢಾಂ ಅಹಂ ಧೀಯಂ ನಿವೇಶ್ಯ ಲಿಂಗಂ ಉತ್ಸೃಜ್ಯ ಕೇವಲೋ ಭವ ಸರ್ವದಾ ಈ ವರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕ ಕೇವಲೋ ಭವ ಸರ್ವದಾ ಸರ್ವದಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ All the time. Kevalo bhava. Kevalo bhava means all the time remain with detachment. Inside, mentally, total detachment. No association. Totally dissociate inside from everything. Because you are that Atma Swarup. Chidatmani sadanande deharudham aham dhiyam niveshya lingam utsrujya. So you resting your thought of so-called I, I am the body. So this ahankara, this I attitude, your buddhi, your manas, everything, on the atma itself, on the pratyekatma, instead of resting your mind on the body and your thoughts on body and the mind complex, remove that, concentrate, rest all your thoughts on the atma itself. Then what happens? Then you must always remember that you are asanga. You are dissociated. You are no more sthula sharira, physical body. Niveshya lingam utsrujya, the word he is using here, Acharya. Lingam utsrujya, lingam means linga sharira. That is sukshma sharira, subtle body. Even you are not that. Utsrujya means give up. Give up. Bittu bido. Neenu sukshma shariru alla. Sthula shariru alla. Neenu kevala atma swarupana gitti. So the point here is, Acharya is indicating to the Shishya all the time that looking into all the previous instruction I have given you, always think, always have that feeling firm that you are no more the physical body. You are not even the sukshma, subtle body, like you are not even antakarana chatushtaya. You are not buddhi, intellect. You are not mind complex. You are not chitta, and you are not ahankara, ego, the I feeling, referring to the body and mind. So that outer I, you are not even that ahankara. So always think like, I am not even any of these antakaranas. I am not even these indriyas. I am not even the pancha pranas traversing in the body. So I am beyond all these things. I am only Atma Swarupa. That's why he says, Lingam Utrujya Kevalo Bhava Sarva. Always be dissociated. Dissociate yourself mentally. Please remember here, to remain silent or to dissociate. Nishkriya and Mauna. To remain silent and to dissociate. Nishkriya means not in the literal sense, because the body cannot stay without doing even a small iota of karma as long as the life is there in the body. Some karma has to be performed. Actions have to be performed. Even if you keep quiet, see, involuntary actions, subtle actions are going on in the body, like respiration, not under your control. Digestion, not under your control. Excretion, not under your control. They're all controlled by the parasympathetic nervous system. In other words, they're all involuntary actions in the body. When you gulp the food into the mouth, into the pharynx, into the gullet here, once it completely you gulp the food, what happens? Then the food passes down the esophagus and to the stomach, and from stomach to the small intestine and the large intestine, all by itself, by the contraction, expansion, movement of the inner muscles of the wall of the either esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, we call it as in biology, simply peristaltic movements. So that is not under your control. You can only gulp the food. Then the food passes through, not by your intention, by its own. We call it as involuntary. They are also karma functions. You cannot control your heartbeat. Heart is beating as long as life is there. It is a karma going on. So the point here is, Toshneem Bhava, remain silent. Kevalo Bhava, remain without action, without association, means mentally dissociate yourself from all the actions. Be a witness. Remain a witness. You are witnessing your own body. You are witnessing your own mind. You are witnessing your own thoughts. You are witnessing your own speech. You are witnessing your own actions. So once you become a pure witness, that ultimately results in what Acharya says, first-hand experience of what is meant by toshnim bhava, to remain silent, to remain actionless, nishkriya. This cannot be explained by words. It has to be experienced. It has to be experienced. So jnana cannot be given by a sadguru to anybody else. He can show the way, whereas the disciple has to perform himself, do the sadhana, and then experience firsthand himself what is jnana. Elsewhere, Acharya has given a beautiful example for this in Vedanta. Very simple example. Anybody can understand. See, for a person who is brought up from the childhood without even seeing, without touching, without tasting, without experiencing the honey made from the honey bees, and then, you know, in the beehive it is stored, and then the people will pluck the beehive and then collect the honey. So a person who has not tasted honey, now the other person, however much he tries to tell him, look, there is a sweet syrup called honey. Have you tasted? Do you know? The other person says, no. Neither he has seen, nor he has heard about it, nor he has tasted. So this person goes on trying to explain, look, honey is a very, very sticky fluid, sticky, watery type fluid. It is something like reddish brown, orange brown, yellow brown, golden brown in color. It is so tasteful, so sweet. When you gulp it in the mouth, you feel so elated. You feel so happy. You feel like eating more and more spoonful of honey. The taste is fantastic. So all the explanation, the person goes on, giving the other person, who has not even seen and tasted honey, can never understand what the other person is talking in front of him. Jenu tuppavanne nodade adara saviyanna nodade irthakkantavanige jenu tuppada saviye bagge eshte vivarane kottru adanige artha agodilla. And only when the person tastes a spoonful of pure honey, then he will understand what honey is, what the sweetness of honey is. Then he will really feel excited, elated, and very happy. Like that, Brahmajnana, salvation, enlightenment, it cannot be explained. The guru can show the way. As a margadarshi, as a guide, he will lead. He will lead you to the path of perfection, and it is left to the shishya, the disciple, to have total faith and surrender at the lotus feet of the guru and continue the sadhana without fail, with utter humility, adhering to the instructions of the guru, fully trusting the words of the guru, advice of the guru, Sadguru. Then the sadhana will culminate and he will have a first-hand experience of his own reality, his swaswarupa, again, by the grace of the Guru, by the grace of Almighty. Now, Acharya comes to the next one. Yatra esha jagadabhaso darpanantah puram yatha tad brahmaham iti jnatva krutakrutyo bhavishyasi. Yatra esha jagadabhaso darpanantah puram yatha tat brahma aham iti jnatva krutakrutyo bhavishyasi. Yatraiva jagadabhaso darpanantah puram yatha. Acharya udaharane kodta idu. ನೀವು ಕನ್ನಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದರೆ, ಕನ್ನಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ದರ್ಪಣ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕನ್ನಡಿ, ದರ್ಪಣಾಂತ ಪುರಂ ಯಥ, ದರ್ಪಣಾಂತ ಪುರಂ ಯಥ, ಒಂದು ಕನ್ನಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಚಿತ್ರವನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಅರಮನೆಯನ್ನೋ ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಟ್ಟಡಗಳು ಒಂದು ಊರಿಂದ ದೂರದಲ್ಲಿ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕನ್ನಡಿಲ ಚಿತ್ರ ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ, ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಆಗಿನ ಕಾಲದ ಬಹಳ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕನ್ನಡಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾಗ ಅದ್ರ ಎದುರುಗಡೆ ಇರೋ ಚಿತ್ರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಕನ್ನಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ದೃಶ್ಯ ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಸ್ಫುಟವಾಗಿ ಕಂಡ್ರು ಅದು ಸತ್ಯ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಬರೀ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು, ಸತ್ಯ ಅಲ್ಲ. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಕನ್ನಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ದುಡ್ಡಿನ ಶೈಲಿ ಕಂಡ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಕೈ ಹಾಕಿ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯಿಂದ ದುಡ್ಡನ್ನು ಎತ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ ಅನ್ನೋ ಭಾವ, ಅದು ಸತ್ಯ ಅಲ್ಲ ಮಿಥ್ಯಾ. ಹಾಗೆ ಆ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ, ಕನ್ನಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಪಟ್ಟಣಗಳ ನಕಾಶೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕಟ್ಟಡಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಅದು ಕೇವಲ ಅಭಾಸ, ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ, ಮಿಥ್ಯಾ, ನಿಜ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗೆ ನಾನು ಈ ದೇಹ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಸ್ವರೂಪನೇ ಆಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ತತ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಂ ಇತಿ ಜ್ಞಾತ್ವಾ ಕೃತಕೃತ್ಯೋ ಭವಿಷ್ಯಸಿ. ಸೊ ಈ ಜಗತ್ತು ನನಗೆ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯೊಳಗೆ ಕಂಡ ಹಾಗೆ, ಈ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ಜಗತ್ತು ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಶಾಶ್ವತ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸುಖ ಆನಂದ ಶಾಶ್ವತ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಅನುಭವಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ದುಃಖ ಇವ್ಯಾವುದು ಶಾಶ್ವತ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಪ್ರತಿ ಕ್ಷಣದಲ್ಲೂ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಜಗತ್ತು. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯೊಳಗೆ ಕಂಡಂತೆ ಈ ಜಗತ್ತು ನಿಜ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ಸತ್ಯವಲ್ಲ ಮಿಥ್ಯಾ ಅಂತ ತಿಳಿದು ಈ ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಕಲ್ಪನೆಯನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ತತ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಂ ಇತಿ ಜ್ಞಾತ್ವಾ ಕೃತಕೃತ್ಯೋ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ, ನಾನು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಸ್ವರೂಪನೇ ಆಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಅಂತ ನಿನಗೆ ಆ ಭಾವ ಬಲ್ಪಿಟ್ರೆ, ಆ ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯ ಆದರೆ ನೀನು ಕೃತಕೃತ್ಯನಾಗ್ತೀಯಪ್ಪ. ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದೆ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ಏನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಿನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕರ್ಮಗಳು ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಟವು ಅಂತ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಸೇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್, ಯತ್ರೈಷ ಜಗದಾಭಾಸೋ ದರ್ಪಣಾಂತ ಪುರಂ ಯಥ ತದ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಹಂ ಇದೆ ಜ್ಞಾತ್ವಾ ಕೃತಕೃತ್ಯೋ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಅಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ದಸ್, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಜಗತ್, ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಪಂಚ, ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಮಾಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಇಮೇಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮಿರರ್, ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಮಿರರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಎನ್ ಇಮೇಜ್, ಎ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ನೋಸ್ ದಟ್, ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ದ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್, ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜಗತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಇಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ eternally changing, not permanent. This jagat is false, mithya, and always remember you are the brahmaswarup. So once you identify yourself correctly, remain in that bhava, sarvatma bhava, I am brahmaswarupa, then you become krutakartya. That means you have achieved everything what is to be achieved in the human life. The very goal, the very purpose of the human life is to know your own reality. Our own reality is to be understood correctly. So once you know that by first hand experience, aparoksha anubhuti, then there is nothing more sadhana left, nothing more for you to do in this life. You become a brahmajnani yourself, atmajnani yourself, you become krutakrutya. Again, that word Acharya is using, you become krutakruti. You have achieved the goal for which you are born. The main purpose of this life itself is to achieve the goal of knowing actually my reality, who really I am. Am I this body with a name, with a status, born to some parents, living in the world? Am I this? or am I something different? So that perception, once you derive internally by the grace of the Sadguru or God, then you become Kritikritya. That's what Acharya says. See, there is the subject matter is so vast about the Jagat. Lot of things are there. So as per the most of the dualistic school of thought, people who believe in dualism while trying to condemn monism, Advaita school of thought, they even start condemning the Advaitic Acharyas also, including Shankaracharya. Swaswaroopa, Sakshat Brahma Swaroopa, Acharya Shankara Bhagavat, even he is being condemned. Why? The argument is how this world, what we are seeing and perceiving, experiencing is false. How the Jagat is false. It cannot be. You are wrong. Jagat cannot be Mithya. Mithya means false. You are sitting in front of me. I am sitting in front of you. Are you false? Are you not seeing me? Am I not observable to you? So many animals, plants and everything. People are there around. Everything is there. Jagat is there. Prapancha is there. Is it false? So for Mithya, word used, a wrong perception is there in the minds of so many people. So Mithya means this is not permanent. This Jagat or Prapancha, Acharya calls Anirvachaniya. It's why he calls Mithya, because this is ever changing, not permanent, ever modifying, transforming. All the time it is born and it will die, born and die. So it is not a constant thing. The way the Brahma, Parabrahma Vastu, supreme consciousness, that unmanifest, that Nirguna Brahma, that is Avikari, Nishchala, Aja, Nitya, Shashvata, no birth and no death. It remains in the same state all the time, whether in the past or present or future. It is beyond the time-space continuum. That real, Nirguna Brahma, Parabrahma Vastu, Paramatma Vastu, that real, primordial, unmanifest, that is responsible for the entire creation. So that is Satya. Whereas the creation, which appears and disappears, is not Satya in that sense. It is Mithya. So, Acharya, that's why he says, Yatraisha Jagadabhaso Darpananta Puramita. So, remove this identification, your association with the Jagat or Prapancha or the universe or your associates, that they are not permanent, they are Mithya. Always have the feeling that you are the Atma Swarup. Tat Brahmaham iti jnatva, he gives the injunction. Remember all the time that you are Brahma Swarupa. You are not the body. You are that Parabrahma Swarupa. You are that Paramachaitanya. You are that Supreme Consciousness. You are that macrocosm. You are that substrate. You are that only. That is your reality. All the time, Acharya is hammering at this point. Point to point and point to point in most of the shlokas. Then yes, yat satya bhotam nijaropamadyam yitadvayanandam aropamakriyam tadetya mitya vapo utsrujeta Shailoshavat Veshamubattam Atmanaha Yas Satya Bhotam Nijaropamadhyam Chit Advayanandam Aropamakriyam Tadetya Mithya Vapu Utsrujeta Shailoshavat Veshamubattam Atmanaha. ಮುಂದಿನ ಶ್ಲೋಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಬಹಳ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧವಾದ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು. ಯಾವ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ? ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ವೇಷಧಾರಿಯ ಪಾತ್ರದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಹಿಂದೆ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸಲ ಇದೇ ಉದಾಹರಣೆಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು. ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ರಾವಣನ ಪಾತ್ರವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಆ ರಾವಣನ ವೇಷಭೂಷ, ರಾವಣನ ನಟನೆ, ಹಾವಭಾವ, ಆತನ ಭಂಗಿ, ಆತನ ಮುಖ, ಕಿರೀಟ, ಕತ್ತಿ ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಆತ ರಾವಣನ ಹಾಗೆ ಪಾತ್ರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ರಾವಣನಾಗೆ ತೋರ್ತಾನೆ ಸಭಿಕರಿಗೆ, ನೋಡೋರಿಗೆ. ಆದರೆ ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ತಾನು ರಾವಣ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ತಾನು ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇವಲ ರಾವಣನ ಪಾತ್ರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ನಾಟಕ ರಂಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ ರಾವಣನ ತರಹ ನಟನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ, ಹಾವಭಾವಗಳು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ, ಸೀತಾ ಮಾತೆಯನ್ನು ಎತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮಚಂದ್ರನಿಂದ ಹತನಾಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಆದರೆ ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ನಾನು ರಾವಣ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಒಬ್ಬ ನಾಟಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ, ಈ ವೇಷ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೆ. ಸದಾಕಾಲ ಆತ ತಾನು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಆತನಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆದರೆ ರಂಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಭಿಕರು ಎದುರಿಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ, ನಾಟಕದ ಪರದೆ ಎಳೆದಾಗ ಆತ ರಾವಣನಾಗಿ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ, ರಾವಣನಾಗಿ ತೋರ್ತೆ. ನೋಡೋರಿಗೆ ಆತ ರಾವಣ. ಆತನಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ನಾನು ರಾವಣ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ನಟ ಕೇವಲ ನಟನೆಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಒಂದು ವೇಷವನ್ನು ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಟನೆ ಮುಗಿದ ನಂತರ ವೇಷವನ್ನು ಕಳಚಿ ತನ್ನ ನಿಜರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾನೋ ಹಾಗೇ ಅನ್ನು ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ಶೈಲೂಷವತ್ ವೇಷಂ ಉಪತ್ತಮಾತ್ಮನಃ ತದ್ ಏತ್ಯ ಮಿಥ್ಯಾ ವಪು ಉತ್ಸೃಜಯಿತ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಈ ಮಿಥ್ಯಾ ಸ್ವರೂಪವಾದ ಈ ದೇಹ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ನಾನು ನಾನು ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀಯಲ್ಲ, ಇದನ್ನು ನೀನು ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಕು. ಹೌದು, ಈ ದೇಹ ಇದೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದು ನೀನಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೋ. ನಾಟಕ ಇದು ನಾಟಕ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೋ ಜಗತ್ತು. ಆ ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿನ್ನ ದೇಹ ಇದೆ, ನಿನ್ನ ದೇಹ ಪಾತ್ರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲೂ ನೀನು ಅದಲ್ಲ ತಿಳ್ಕೋ ಅಂತ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯತ್ ಸತ್ಯಭೂತಂ ನಿಜ ರೂಪ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮ ಅದ್ವಯಾನಂದಂ ಅರೂಪಮ ಕ್ರಿಯಂ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ನೀನು ಯಾರಪ್ಪ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು? ಮೊದಲನೇ ಎರಡು ಚರಣ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನೀನು ಸತ್ಯಭೂತನಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ನಿಜರೂಪನಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಅನಾದಿಯಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಹುಟ್ಟು ಸಾವು ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಚಿತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪನಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಅದ್ವಯಾನಂದ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ರೂಪವೇ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಕ್ರಿಯೆ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ಸ್ವರೂಪನಾಗಿ, ಘನಸ್ವರೂಪನಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಆತ್ಮನೇ ನೀನು. ಹಾಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಒಬ್ಬ ವೇಷಧಾರಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ನಟನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೋ ಹಾಗೆ ನೀನು ಈ ದೇಹವನ್ನ ನಾನು ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳದೆ ನೀನು ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನಟನ ಹಾಗೆ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದು ಬಿಡಬೇಕು. ನಿಜವಾದ ನೀನು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ನಿನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು. ಈ ದೇಹ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು ವೇಷ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು ನಿನಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ವಾಟ್ ಎ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್. ಯತ್ ಸತ್ಯಭೂತಂ ನಿಜರೂಪ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮ ಚಿತ್ ಅದ್ವಯಾನಂದ ರೂಪಂ ಅರೂಪಂ ಅಕ್ರಿಯಂ ಯುವಾ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ. ತತ್ ಏತ್ಯ, ತತ್ ಏತ್ಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ಡ್. ತದೇತ್ಯ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್? ಯು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಸತ್ಯ ಸ್ವರೂಪ, ಯು ಆರ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ದಟ್ ನಿಜಸ್ವರೂಪ, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಆನಂದ ಸ್ವರೂಪ, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೈಮಾರ್ಡಿಯಲ್ ಸನಾತನ ಅವ್ಯಕ್ತ, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೈಮಾರ್ಡಿಯಲ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಸ್ತು, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಚಿತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪ, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಅದ್ವಯಾನಂದ ಸ್ವರೂಪ. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಆನಂದ ಸ್ವರೂಪ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಅರೂಪಂ ಅಕ್ರಿಯಂ, ಯು ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ಲೆಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಫೇಸ್ಲೆಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ. ಅಕ್ರಿಯಂ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೋಷನ್ಲೆಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಲೆಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಲೆಸ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ವಸ್ತು. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ನೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಗಿವ್ ಅಪ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ಮಿಥ್ಯಾವಪು, ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್. ಯುವರ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ದಿ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್, ದಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೋ ಸೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೋ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಿಥ್ಯಾ. ಸೊ ಗಿವ್ ಅಪ್ ಉತ್ಸೃಜೇತ ಮಿಥ್ಯಾವಪು. ಉತ್ಸೃಜೇತ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ಅಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ನೋಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. mithya vapuhu. Vapu means body. Sharira, we give up. The false. Just like shailoshavad vesham upattamatmanaha. Just like Acharya is giving the famous example of the dramas. In those days, 1,000 years before, there were no TV and films as we can see nowadays. So only dramas used to be there as the source of entertainment for the people, for the audience. So he's taking that famous example of the drama. Acharya says, elsewhere he has given the same example. See, if a person is enacting a role of Ravana in a drama on Ramayana, once he dons the makeup and all the dress befitting the king Ravana and enters the stage, how he behaves, how he talks, just like Ravana himself. The typical Asura character, Rakshasa character, demonic character of Ravana, he exhibits with full gusto. And people will sometimes clap also for the wonderful acting he's showing. But all the time, the person who is enacting the Ravana role knows that he is not a Ravana. He's only enacting the role of Ravana on the stage for the sake of the audience. So he knows that very well. After the drama is over, he will remove the makeup, he will remove the dress of Ravana, he will wear his normal dress and he will go back as a normal person. So no more he is Ravana while acting also, later also. It was pure acting. So Acharya hints here how a jnani remains in the world of Maya, Jagat, which is Mithyasu. Our Gurudev has beautifully explained this point, you know, at some context. A jnani knows very well that he is surrounded by the Jagat or Samsara, full of Maya. He has awakened from the false dream called Jagat. He has awakened himself, but still he is surrounded by the Maya, Jagat, all the time till his body is sustained, according to Prarabdha, till the death occurs to the body. So he is around, surrounded by the Maya or the Jagat people. But at the same time, he knows there is only one Brahma Padartha, and he is that Brahma Padartha. Everywhere only Brahma is seen, Brahma is pervading as Adhishthana. So he is always Sarvatma Bhava. He is in the Brahma Bhava all the time. So our Gurudev used to tell this point so beautifully. A jnani, no doubt will see, no doubt will talk with his lips and the tongue. No doubt he will hear with his ears. No doubt he will touch. No doubt he will smell. And no doubt he will do actions, perform karmas. But the difference is, an awakened Mahapurusha, a Paramajnani, a Brahmajnani, or an Atmajnani, how he behaves, he will be experiencing simultaneously the Brahma Padartha everywhere, and he is nothing but the same Brahma Padartha, the same inside and outside, that is pervading everywhere, and it is exhibiting itself in the form of the universe, in the form of Sthavara and Jangama, in the form of moving and non-moving objects, in the form of animals and plants, in the form of living and non-living, animate and inanimate things. So he will be experiencing both. So he is no more affected by the Maya or the delusion of this world called Jagat. So that's how beautifully he gave a sermon on this Jagat. So it is very difficult for normal people to understand what a jnani thinks and jnani says, a paramajnani behaves. That's why behavior of a jnani, nature of a jnani cannot be understood by a common mortal person. Because no two jnanis are equal in their behavior, in their observing rituals or any traditions or whatever you call. the way of their life is totally different. Totally different. Very unassuming sometimes. Very demanding sometimes. So you cannot quantify, you cannot codify. There are no rules, set rules for a jnani, how to behave, how not to behave. So these are the points we had to remember. So ultimately the point here is, Acharya says, you be an actor in the life. Just like the person who is enacting the role of Ravana all the time knows that he is not a Ravana himself. He is an individual by his own name and status. You be an actor in the life itself. Be an actor, always focus inside onto the locus of Brahmapada. You are that Atmaswarupa. So let your mind be focused on the locus of Atma, Pratyagatma, inside. But outside, you be a perfect actor. Do all your duty, do all your karma selflessly with a devotion, with a Shraddha, like any other person. Service to the mankind, service to the humanity, service in the samsara, everything should be done. All the duties have to be performed very diligently and correctly, our Gurudev used to say. But inside, always remember, be an actor, very good actor, very good actor. Dissociate yourself from inside. This is how he used to teach. This is how he used to show. This is how he used to advise. Great, our Gurudev. So with Guru Sankalpa, we are stopping today at the shloka number 291, we are stopping today. That is Adhyasa. Prakarana is over. Sri Rama Jaya Rama Jaya Jaya Rama. 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 Hari Om Tat Sat. Om Namo Bhagavate Virajishta.
Hari Om, sir.
Hari Om.
Thank you so much for this again.
Hari Om.